Hey guys, I am enjoying a very hot cup of tea with honey. I'm still so sick. Today I woke up worse. It was insane. I did my makeup a little extra today just because I look like real cow poo. It's gross. So anyways, hello you guys. I'm so sorry about sounding all disgusting and looking like poo, but honestly I have been feeling so horrible lately. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoy this makeup tutorial. I don't know, it is kind of like a get ready with me because I'm going out. It was nothing planned. I didn't know what I was gonna do, but this is the look. I feel like it's super warm. I love warm tones, you guys know. And I really wanted to show you guys how the Canary Island bronzer by Sephora is. This is the bomb. Oh my gosh. I extremely recommend it. It really exceeded every expectation I had. It is $21 and I think it's worth every single penny. I really, really do love this. So extremely recommend Canary Islands by Sephora. Also guys, don't forget to follow me on Instagram. That is just MorelletM. I will also leave my YouTube channel in Spanish linked down below. And if you're not already, please subscribe to my channel and just hit the subscribe button. Thank you so much for all the sweet comments that I got on my September favorites. I was really sick still then. And all of you guys just wish me to get better and everybody was being so sweet. I really thank you guys so much. You really mean a lot to me and it really means a lot to me that you're watching right now, right this moment, right this tutorial. So with no further ado, I will introduce you guys to this makeup tutorial that I have right here. And yeah, so thank you so much for watching and I will see you on my next tutorial. Bye. For primer today, I'm using the SMASHBOX Photo Finish Foundation Primer and then I'm going to go ahead and apply my foundation. Today I'm using the Lock It Tattoo Foundation by Kat Von D in the shade 52 and I'm just going to apply this all over the face. To conceal my under eye circles, I'm using the Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer and the LA Girl Pro in yellow. And I'm just going to apply the Maybelline first. And then I'm going to go ahead and apply that on the forehead, on the chin, and along my mouth. And this is going to also give me a little bit of a highlight. And now I'm just applying the yellow concealer by LA Girl. Following that, I'm just going to blend that out with my damp beauty blender. This is the worst time to do a voiceover, but it sounded worse to do a talk through. So we're gonna have to do with this voice for now. To contour, I'm using this concealer by LA Girl as well, and this one's in the shade Toffee, and I'm just going to apply that on the hollows of my cheeks, on the forehead, on the sides of the forehead, and on my jawline. And I'm also going to draw two parallel lines along my nose bridge, and this is going to create an illusion of me having a nose bridge. And right after, I'm going to go ahead and blend everything out with my damp beauty blender, and I had to hurry because this product does dry very quickly. Now I'm going to take my Maybelline concealer and I'm going to draw a line underneath my contour, and this is going to really sharpen that cheek contour, which I really liked for today. I don't do this every day, but today was okay. Now I'm taking the NYC Smooth Skin Loose Powder and I'm just going to apply that with a sponge, and I'm going to bake my under eyes, and I'm just going to pack a lot of this product underneath the eyes. I'm also doing it on the Cupid's bow and on the chin. Brows are done off camera. I have an updated brow routine. Once I filled the brows, I gave my powder enough time to settle, and then now I'm just going to buff everything away. Taking the Kat Von D Shading Light Contour, I'm going to go ahead and do a powder contour on my nose. I'm not going to go in depth with this part because I do have a nose contour tutorial and I will link it down below.
To allow my eyeshadows to last all day, I'm taking Soft Ochre Paint Pot by MAC. And because it does dry tacky, I'm going to run along a nude or white eyeshadow. And this is going to make the tackiness go away. And it's also going to be really helpful to me when I applied eyeshadows. And it's going to be a lot easier to blend. For the eyes, I'm taking this light orange eyeshadow. And I'm just going to apply that on the crease. And this is going to be my transition shade. Next, I'm grabbing a darker orange eyeshadow and I'm also going to apply that on the crease. And all we're doing here is building up the shadows and giving my eye a little bit of definition. Taking a dark brown eyeshadow with the MAC 217 brush, I'm going to really carve out that crease area and then I'm going to really pack it on and slowly build up the brown until I'm satisfied. And then I'm just going to softly blend it with a fluffy brush because I want everything to be blended and I do not want any harsh lines. Now going in with the oldest MAC eyeshadows in the world. I don't even know what palette this is. I don't have any names. This is so beat up, honestly, but it's still a really good eyeshadow palette. But all I'm going to do is I'm going to mix the corner white eyeshadow with a pinky tone eyeshadow. And then I'm just going to pack this on the lid with a flat brush. Once I do that, I'm also going to take that mix of eyeshadows and I'm going to apply that on the tear duct area. And this is going to give me a little bit of highlight on the inner part of the eye. And whatever's left over in the brush, I'm going to apply that underneath the brow bone. And this is also going to be a highlight. And going back, blending all the shadows together so that there are no harsh lines. Back with the 217 brush, I'm taking a tiny little bit of the brown eyeshadow. And I'm just carving out the crease once more because of all the blending, I lost a little bit of intensity. Now taking my NYC liquid eyeliner, I'm going to go ahead and do my wing line. And lately I've been running the Maybelline Eye Studio Blackest Black Gel Liner and I just go over the NYC one because the gel liner is a lot more darker and I feel that it makes my wing super sharp and super dark. I did make a boo on the eyeliner though. I was trying to even it out, but it turned out that every time I was trying to do something, it was just making it thicker and thicker and thicker. And I ended up with this super thick eyeliner, which I did not mean to happen, but it did. So we're going with it. Once I do the eyeliner, I'm going to go ahead and apply any mascara to my upper lashes. And today I'm going to be using falsies and these are the Coco Lashes in the style Soho. And while the lash glue dries, I'm going to move on to my bottom lash line. I'm going to take the dark brown eyeshadow and I'm just going to run that along the bottom lash line and really smoke it out. But I did grab a little bit of the orange as well and also applied it on top of the brown eyeshadow just to blend it out a little bit. Next, I'm just applying any white eyeliner on the waterline. Now their lashes are tacky, so I'm just going to apply those on. After that, I'm taking my L'Oreal Telescopic Mascara and I'm just going to coat my baby lashes. I do like the wand for the application of mascara on the lower lashes because they're so tiny and so is the wand. Now taking my favorite bronzer at the moment, which is the Sephora Canary Island in the shade 07. And I'm just going to go ahead and start contouring with this. I forgot how pigmented this was, so I did go a little bit overboard, but don't you worry, we know how to blend here. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna blend the shit out of it. I'm also going to apply that on the forehead, on the sides of the forehead, and on my jawline. Once I contour, I'm going to go ahead and take my Mary Luminizer by the Balm, and this is a highlighter, and I'm just going to pop that on the apples of the cheeks, a little bit on the bridge of the nose, And then I'm also going to apply that a little bit above the eyebrow and with a smaller brush. And I'm going to apply the highlighter on the Cupid's bow and give myself a milk mustache. Now for blush, I'm going to go very light. I'm taking Margin by MAC and I'm just going to apply that on the apples of the cheeks. This is one of my favorite blushes in the world. For the lips today, I'm using Whirl by MAC and I'm just going to line my lips. I have to be extremely careful with Whirl because if I do overline my lips a tiny little bit, it's going to make me like the worst Kylie Jenner lip in the world. So with Whirl, what I do is I actually underline my lips because this liner, all it does, it creates that shadow which gives a definition. So if I overline my lips, I'm going to look like sausage lips. And by underlining my lips, I actually make them look as big as they naturally are, if you know what I mean. I'm using one of my favorite drugstore lipsticks, which is 655, and it's by Maybelline, and it's called Daringly Nude. And to finish the look off, I am taking a bath in MAC's Fix Plus. And this is going to set my makeup so it lasts me all day. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. And don't forget to subscribe. I only call you when it's